Now, unemployment is a prominent issue among Nigerian youth, and with over 13 million unemployed youths in the country, the need for empowering them with trade skills cannot be overstated. To this end, entrepreneurial skills are of great importance in equipping young Nigerians with the skills needed to survive and thrive in the current economy. This includes skills such as plumbing, carpentry, and electrical installations. By discussing the topic of entrepreneurship skills to empower Nigeria's youth population, it will shine a light on how these skills can help combat unemployment, promote entrepreneurship, and boost the nation's economy. As unemployment looms large among Nigeria's youth population, it is daily creating a pressing need for viable solutions. Well, joining us now to chart a path towards a youth entrepreneurship and job opportunity for the teeming youth population, rather, is Chinny Love Eze Ogunje, a philanthropist and filmmaker. It's amazing to have you on a Newsday.
Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to be here.
Thank you so much for being here. Before we even go into the crux of today's topic, I want to find out exactly what inspired your passion for addressing unemployment issues, particularly the focus on Nigerian youth. I mean, it's very important that you are here, but what led to this?
So basically, you know, when I finished school, it was really easier to, you know, to finish school and then get a job. You know, that we had the likes of a lot of telecommunications and banks just zapping in a lot of young people from school. But right now we realize that, you know, the unemployment rate is very high. So most people, you know, right from school already know that, you know what, when I'm done with school, I would just look for something to do. You know, I'll either be a makeup artist or, you know, I'll sell hair or be a businesswoman or something. So that's like where majority of, you know, the Nigerian youth are, you know, getting into. So I feel like there is a need to, you know, empower people, especially in this skill, because I mean, nobody's really getting jobs like that anymore. So it's more like you're in your final year. You already know that I'm going to go into the world. I'm going to have to, you know, fight for myself. I have to do something. And, you know, in every area of whatever you want to do, there are already a lot of people doing it. So it's how you want to be best at it. You know, so that's really what led to my, you know, my interest in empowering people, because right now, people are self-employed. Almost a lot of youth are self-employed. You know, some people do not have the finance to start. Some people just, you know, so that's it for me. And then also as a woman, I have a lot of young female, you know, I would say that, say I mentor them, you know, so to speak. So a lot of people reach out to me and say, oh, this, and I know how I started. I never worked a day, like, you know, 9 to 5. I never worked 9 to 5. So I started up as an entrepreneur. So I understand it, and I know how many people I mentor. So it's just like something that I'm very passionate about, you know, empowering people, you know, entrepreneurship.
It's good you mentioned something, you know, you're passionate about, and of course, regarding that. But realistically, where is Nigeria on youth development and entrepreneurship? Do you think there's a national policy on this, or it's just an individual effort?
It is an individual effort, I'm sorry to say, but it is a lot of people have just kind of given up. And, you know, I mean, we have a lot of policies sometimes, but how much often do we have them implemented? You know, we can have policies on, you know, agriculture, on, you know, whatever, you know, but how many times do we have it implemented? So most people know that these are just policies that are, you know, dished out every other year, but how many times do we see, you know, the government really going? So people just decide to, you know, do things for themselves. So I feel like most people are, nobody really, you know, wants to follow that policy. Everybody's just trying to fend for themselves in whatever way they can legally. Yeah.
All right then. You know, it's interesting that you said, you know, Nigerian youth, they can, you know, fend for themselves, because I remember when the term lazy Nigerian youth was a thing. But I think that the young Nigerians have proven over and over again that is not the case.
Nigerians are not lazy.
Now, given the diverse challenges faced by, let's say, the unemployed youth now, how do you tailor your approach to ensure that the entrepreneurial skills offered align with the current market trends? Because it's, you know, it's one thing to, you know, just train people, but there's another thing to make sure that they are equipped for, I guess, to bridge the gap that's currently missing. Yes.
You know, basically, like I said, in every field right now, there are people doing, you know, stuff. But I feel like when I mentor people, I always say to people that look for a service. You can't come and meet me and tell me, oh, Chini, come and give me money. No, look for something that appeals to me. Look for a service. You have to offer me, render me a service. Do you understand? So I want to assume that when you finish and you want to become an entrepreneur, you have to sit back and say, okay, what service can I offer Nigerians that is in demand? You know, there are people there, but I mean, no matter how many people, we still have people buying your service because it has to be service driven. You have to be able to offer people service. So if you feel like, oh, I mean, let's take makeup because I'm kind of women, you know, so let's take makeup, for instance. Before, the amount of times that people employ makeup artists, you can't compare it to now because if you want to, any event you want to go for, if you want to even go for an interview, if you want to go for premiere, anything, you have to have makeup. So we have people employing more makeup artists, more hands as compared to maybe 4 years ago. So I would not expect you finish and then just, you know, so I always tell people, tailor it to what is in demand. Tailor what you want to service, you know, to what is in demand so that you can have a greater chance, you know. I mean, for women especially, a lot of women go into beauty. We see that no matter how populated that side is, there is still a lot of demand in that side. So, you know, even IT, you know, there's a lot of demand in IT internationally, locally, there's a lot. So just find what you think, you know, tailor your service to what is in demand. And I think,
I also wanted to follow up on something she said, because, you know, you had spoken about how you personally mentor people, but it's a very tricky place to be, and I'm speaking from personal experience. Now, I want to ask how you're able to connect aspiring young entrepreneurs with experienced mentors in their field, because it can be easy during that matchup, and you can't take everybody on. So how do you do that?
So basically, like my event, for instance, I have some speakers from people that are, you know, top in their fields. And I personally always try to encourage people that are already very big to try and take on people, like a lot of younger people, because however we look at it, younger people need mentorship, right? And they need the push. They need the drive. They need that mentorship. So I tried, like, my event, right, is even geared towards that, because I have, you know, speakers from, like, you know, the corporate, beauty, entertainment, and I also reach out and say, you know what, please, just let's take on. So I respect that people that come for the event, for instance, would, you know, try and key into, I mean, network, try and key into this, you know, people. I won't do everything. I'll only mentor the people that I can. Yeah. But for the wider audience and all of that, I think you need to just, you know, reach out to people that are in your field and try and, you know, connect on your own. You know, go for events, go for networking events where you meet people, and, you know, I think that's basically it.
Almost falls in line with what the former Minister of Interior said, mm-hmm. you know, Ralph Arebeshola, where if you have the opportunity to be able to give back to society, yeah. make sure you do what you can to help
indeed.
With the social reform.
Yes.
All right, Chini, these days it's all about moving abroad to seek greener pastures, an individual choice nonetheless. So how's brain drain syndrome affecting youth entrepreneurship based on, you know, from your experience mentoring?
Yeah, it is. I like God, it is. You know why? Because, you know, I remember years back, the quality of, you know, when you even, because I do a lot of recruitment, so the quality of people that you recruit those days, you can't match, you can't, there's a big gap. There's a total big gap. A lot of people say there's no job. There's no quality. And this is because a lot of people have actually left. And then the ones that we even have already have that mindset of, it's not going to work anyway. Mind what I want to, even the ones that are here that are still doing stuff, they still intend to, so they're not putting in their best. So it is affected. I think a lot of the best brains have left. I have had opportunities even, you know, many years ago to have, you know, maybe been a citizen of another country, but I have been a firm believer of Nigeria. I've been a strong, firm believer of this country. I've said, no, I don't want, you know, my parents, I don't want this. I want to be here. So, but we do not have a lot of these people anymore believing in Nigeria. So we've had a lot of, you know, very, you know, our good talent, our, you know, strong, everybody has left. So it is affected. If you interview people, you realize that there are jobs, but there are no people to fill in the jobs. It's so bad. It's so bad. So it has really, really affected it. And I'm hoping that there's something that is done about it, because the brain drain, it's especially for me, because I am an entrepreneur and I deal with a lot of youth, and I do a lot of recruitment. And then when I see people, and then you ask basic questions, you say, okay, can you use an Excel? You know, just basic things that you expect. And I'm like, and because they don't care, they just feel like, I will sell here. I don't need all of that.
Another thing that you need
to for the help.
Yeah, if you don't mind me. Also, you know, another thing is this concept of hard work. You know, it's like the youth these days, like they want quick returns. That mindset, you know, in your mentorship experiences, do you also counter that every now and then?
Yes.
It's not just about they want everything
that
done.
That is what Be More is about. I'm a product of hard work. I have worked hard from the very beginning. I have never gotten anything for free. I have never, like, I have attained everything that I have right now from pure hard work. And I believe that, you know, and I've seen people work hard, and I've seen people become very successful working hard. Yes, there is that thing of, it's not by working hard.
Hot corners.
Yes, a lot of people that are showing us this, they did not work hard for it. Mm. But there are people that are toiling, that are working hard. And it's now, the narrative have even changed, because even when you work hard and promote what you've achieved, people say, oh, that's what you're showing us. Really, really, that's not how you got it. So they're really killing that narrative of working hard. But I feel like with more of this programs and more of these events that are being had, it's tailored majorly into letting the younger ones know that hard work pays. You cannot run away from it. Hard, genuine work pays. It will pay off. I'm a product of it. I know a lot of people that are products of it, and it hurts me and it kills me a lot of times when I see that the narrative is changing. A lot of people want quick money, quick cash. You know, I can do this, I can do that. Nobody wants to. And for me, I'm very big on training the woman, because I feel like, you know, if you train a woman, you've trained it, you know what they say. Mm-hmm. And also because women are the ones that are quick to say, I beg, I'm not, you know, so I'm very big on training women, because I feel like if you put your mind into it, if you work hard, you can get to the peak. So that is what my mentorship programs that I've ever done is always about: working hard, your mindset. And first, the mindset has to even change. There has to be a shift to understand that it would pay. Nobody wants to be patient. It took me 10 years. I'm a filmmaker. It took me 10 years to actually get to where I am today, but nobody wants to grow. Mm. You want to do a film now and boom.
Let me just say that, because we're going very quickly. Okay. If you can just give us more in-depth information about Be More as we start to wrap up.
Okay. So Be More is an empowerment program where we empower women to become more. Because, so if you see the tagline is women can be more, I believe that women can be more. So if I am very passionate about the women, I'm very passionate about the girl child, I want to make sure that in every capacity, you maximize it to the fullest. So Be More is just an empowerment program where we bring in like very bright minds together, we empower them, and then we also give out, you know, for people that want to start businesses that do not have access to funding, you know, we hear your pitch and all that and see how best we can help funding wise. So that's basically what Be More is about. It's just an empowerment program to empower women to change their mindset, to becoming more and to becoming better, and to also contribute their quota to Nigeria, because it's very important, you know, to make sure that, you know, we become more, and, you know, as women.
All right, on that note, Sir Chinelove Eze Ogunje, a filmmaker, philanthropist, many thanks for your thoughts on the topic, youth entrepreneurship,
yes,
as it were.
Thank
it's good to have you with
much.
Us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.